Today, we're diving into the top to-do list applications as we head into 2023. These are great to-do list applications for personal use and a little bit of team use. We're going to be diving into the best recommended ones as we head into the new year. So some housekeeping before we begin. My name is Francesco D'Alessio. Welcome to Keep Productive. If you are interested, do subscribe, check out our newsletters below, and also a brand new site, Tool Finder, if you're interested in diving into more depth in each of these applications. That's important because we're going to be covering them very briefly in today's video. If you want to find out more depth, you can find that link in the description below. So all the housekeeping done, let's dive into these applications. So in no particular order, let's start with the first one. The first one is TickTick. Now, TickTick has been a long-standing one on the market, and what I would say is currently it's the best budget to-do list application, and it does offer great value inside of it, offering a calendar in their premium, Kanban boards, as well as more specialized features like Pomodoro timers, all inside their different applications. Now, to be honest, TickTick is one of those most value, most budget applications on the market, and it's great for those who are beginners, but also those who want to take it a little bit step further in organization systems. Numero two, Todoist. We love Todoist here. It's one of our favorite applications, mainly because it's so reliable, it's so gorgeous looking, and it's really easy to use. I typically always recommend this for people who are looking for to-do lists and don't necessarily want a complex system, but have the ability to grow with it. Because what you can do in Todoist is grow from a beginner all the way to somebody with a more intricate system. And Todoist does offer all of that under one roof. They're also producing better abilities with boards, and some of their project templates are getting more advanced, which does help you to grow with the application. Next up, number three is Things3. Now, this I would say is the best minimal application on the market. If you're looking for something really relaxed, really simple in its look, you found a home on Things3. And whilst it does have a high one-off cost, you do not have to pay a recurring subscription for it. And once you're under that, you can naturally use it as long as you want and as far as you want into the future. Things3 offers a really nice canvas, and what people do like about it is being able to break down projects and areas inside of your account so that you can focus more on deadline-based projects and add tasks within them, using headers to organize and coordinate them too. And what I really like inside of Things3 in particular is the way that they structure it as well, with Sunday and the ability to add things to the evening too. This is something I used for a little bit of time and I really did like, but I do find that it is a little bit Apple-centric if you're somebody that only wants to use it on Windows or web, which you cannot. So number four is Microsoft To-Do. This is Microsoft's go-to task management application. And if you compare it to something like Google Tasks, which is Google's version, it blows it out the water. Now, Microsoft a couple of years ago bought something called Wunderlist. Now, they acquired this and turned this into Microsoft To-Do. And to be honest, it's probably the best free to-do list application on the market. It offers a great experience. And one thing in particular is sharing lists with other people. If you're looking for something more advanced than Apple Reminders and you want to share lists between people who have an account, in particularly in college, university, education, things like that, then this is a really nice experience for that. And you can use the beautiful themes that have been brought over from Wunderlist too. So number five is AkiFlow. Now, this has really come on in the last 2 years. AkiFlow is more of a consolidation tool. And you're probably wondering, Francesco, don't use complicated words like consolidation. That is complicated. Consolidation, it basically means bringing together things from other applications. So inside of AkiFlow, you can actually bring in tasks from things like Trello, ClickUp, and Todoist, and bring them all into one location, even Notion inside of databases, which is pretty cool. And that's quite nice because if you're somebody that's in a team and you're like, I need to use these team tools that we use for work, but I want my own system of organizing, then AkiFlow gives you that. It's almost like a central hub to planning your workload, because you still want to be able to bring them in, you don't want to replicate them, and that's quite a nice experience for that. And it's got some good calendar abilities for plotting out and time blocking more effectively. So that's a handy one, and one that is a bit more expensive, $15 per month at the moment, so you're looking at a much steeper price for that in the market compared to what's on the market. So the same goes for the next one and the next one after that. Number six is Motion. Now, not Notion, Motion. Motion is a AI-based scheduling application that allows you to plan and coordinate your to-do list. Now, primarily it's being used by those who are quite time poor, but also don't want to necessarily hire like an assistant, ones who have quite a high budget for their to-do's experience, much higher than something like Todoist or TickTick, but offer a way to organize your tasks automatically around meetings. So this is great for the more advanced to-do list user, someone who is really struck by a lot of meetings and has a lot of tasks and wants the system to be able to organize it for them. Motion is doing some really interesting stuff in that market. So number seven is something that I actually use. We have a video on it if you're interested in how I use it, is Sansama. Now, the reason why I like Sansama is because it's a to-do list application, but what it does differently is it's a bit more mindful about how much time you spend at work, putting limitations on that. But what's nice about it is you can plan your day using what I like to call the hand-holding. So essentially in Sansama, what you can do is basically go through a set way to plan a day and close a day off so that you're guiding yourself through the experience, like planning, working out what's too much on your workload, bringing in stuff from your backlog and other applications. And it works similar to AkiFlow in bringing and consolidating other apps in your ecosystem. So Sansama, again, is much more priced, but I really like the way that it's more mindful in its approach. Okay, let's take a pause here. If you're interested in checking out the full list and the full depth, you can check out Toolfinder in the link in description. That's our site for diving into productivity apps. It's like the Wikipedia for productivity apps. You can find that linked in description below. So AnyDo. AnyDo is our number eight, and it's a great all-rounder. I really like the way that AnyDo is designed. It's like a calendar and a to-do list combined in one, and I particularly like how they use their Moments ability. I believe Moments is a part of their premium experience, but it guides you through whether a task is relevant or not and helps you to clear your to-do list really fast. The Moments ability is really nice, but all in all, as a package, AnyDo is a nice one. If you're looking for something a little bit more advanced than, say, Microsoft To-Do, but not as advanced as, say, Todoist could be, I think it's a nice sweet spot there and has a great minimal design too. Number nine, Moleskine Actions have released a brand new version 3.0. We actually did a feature on it if you're interested in diving into more depth. And to be honest, it's a fairly basic application in its structure. It allows you to create to-dos, assign them to lists, and create subtasks within them, but also give them due dates and deadline dates as well. Now, one thing I really like about this is available on iOS and Android, but it's also gorgeously designed. They've done a great job with this. It's on web as well, and it has a really nice experience. If you've used any of the Moleskine Suite applications, you'll really like how they've designed them. But what's important is when you pay for the Moleskine Suite, you also get the other applications within it. And Moleskine Timepage is a great calendar app, and Moleskine Flow is also a great note-taking application if you're an iPad and iPad Pencil user. So number 10, Zenkit To-Do. We talk about Zenkit To-Do. It's very much like Wunderlist in a sense. Looks like Wunderlist, works like Wunderlist, and it does give you a good freemium option, but a lot of the benefits are packed under the premium account. Now, it's great for organizing your to-dos, and very much like Todoist, offers that beginner to complexity structure, although I would probably recommend Todoist for more beginner users over something like Zenkit To-Do. But if you're looking for something that ties into, very much like Moleskine, a suite of applications, then it does have Zenkit Suite, which has other note-taking apps and also project management applications. So worth a look if you're looking for a whole systematized process. Habitica, if you're looking to gamify your experience as a task management goes, maybe you struggle with your habits and your tasks in one location and you actually struggle to do them because there's no incentive, there's no feel or intensification to it. Well, Habitica can actually do that for you. It gamifies it by making it feel like an RPG game, in a sense, almost like a micro version of Pokemon inside of your to-do list experience, and a lot of people really like it. It's got a very social element to it as well. Number 11, To-Do. This application is much more of a legacy application, hasn't really been touched in a couple of years, but it provides a good one-off cost application that goes much further than apps like Todoist and Zenkit, but also offers some more advanced structures if you're somebody that loves GTD. We'll probably do a separate list for GTD, Getting Things Done, a book by David Allen, that focuses on his system process, but this application is a good one if you're looking for more one-off options on the market. Number 13, Google Tasks. Google is obviously offering pretty good task management. And if you're somebody that really likes super light task management and doesn't really care too much about it, then Google Tasks is a pretty good option. It has an iOS and Android application, but what I think people like about it is you can drag Gmail emails into it from the toolbar. And a lot of people like doing that and being able to have that there. And you can now connect it up with more of your Google Docs experience if you're looking to work on tasks with team members, if you have a Google Workspace account. But a great all-round type application, but very much simplicity focused with Google Tasks. Finally, number 14, Apple Reminders. To be honest, this is a great application for somebody's wanting to keep it simple, but it does have some more advanced abilities like Smart Lists that can take it a step further. Now, if you're somebody that's Apple-centric, uses Mac and iOS, and even on the old iWatch, then this could be a good application for you to bring all of those into one roof. And simple, easy, has some advanced abilities, but only if you need it at a glance. Anyway, folks, that was our top to-do list applications of 2023. Now, I have likely missed some. I cover lots of tools, but if you have one that you are loving at the moment, feel free to share it in the link in description. Do not share the link because it will likely be flagged as spam automatically by YouTube's operating system, but do share the title of it below and use it as a way to share your experience with it. How have you got on with that application? And where do you work? How do you find it combines with your role and your work that you do every day? So a big thank you for stopping by. As I mentioned, I would love to have you as a subscriber. My name is Francesco. You can ask me any questions in the comments below. And if you need any help whatsoever, I'm more than happy to help. Thank you very much, folks. And I look forward to seeing you in a future video here on Kick Productive. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here. And also you can subscribe to as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Tool Finder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.